Energizing your soul through the inspired word of God. This is your daily devotional reading.
Maranatha, the Lord is coming. A devotional by Ellen White. June 6th. Apostasy prepares the way. Sweet promises given to all who believe. Behold, I come quickly, mine own to receive. Hold fast till I come. The danger is great. Sleep not as do others. Be watchful and wait. Hold fast till I come. Sweet promise of heaven, the kingdom restored to you shall be given. Come enter my joy. Sit down on my throne. Bright crowns are in waiting. Hold fast till I come.
Apostasy prepares the way. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 3. When the early church became corrupted by departing from the simplicity of the gospel and accepting heathen rites and customs, she lost the spirit and power of God. And in order to control the consciences of the people, she sought the support of the secular power. The result was the papacy, a church that controlled the power of the state and employed it to further her own ends, especially for the punishment of heresy. Whenever the church has obtained secular power, she has employed it to punish dissent from her doctrines. Protestant churches that have followed in the steps of Rome by forming alliance with worldly powers have manifested a similar desire to restrict liberty of conscience. An example of this is given in the long-continued persecution of dissenters by the Church of England. During the 16th and 17th centuries, thousands of nonconformist ministers were forced to flee from their churches, and many, both of pastors and people, were subjected to fine, imprisonment, torture, and martyrdom. It was apostasy that led the early church to seek the aid of the civil government, and this prepared the way for the development of the papacy, the beast. Said Paul, "There shall come a falling away, and that man of sin be revealed." 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 3. So apostasy in the church will prepare the way for the image to the beast. Satan will work with all power and with all deceivableness of unrighteousness. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verses 9 and 10. His working is plainly revealed by the rapidly increasing darkness, the multitudinous errors, heresies, and delusions of these last days. Not only is Satan leading the world captive, but his deceptions are leavening the professed churches of our Lord Jesus Christ. The great apostasy will develop into darkness, deep as midnight. To God's people, it will be a night of trial, a night of weeping, a night of persecution for the truth's sake. But out of that night of darkness, God's light will shine. Maranatha, the Lord is coming.
I encourage you to be ye doers of the word and not hearers only. Thank you for listening, and be sure to join us tomorrow for your daily devotional reading.